Thursday night, James was ordained, James Boyd, as a minister. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And today, I want us to be able to have our own ordination service. Amen. In front of those who could not participate and attend the services. And James, I will tell you, I looked for my robe and I couldn't find it. I asked, we looked all over for it. I couldn't find it. I was going to wear it today and bless you for your pictures and such, but I dressed up the best that I could. I cleaned up, brother. Amen. Would you come on up here? Amen. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Folks, would you turn your Bibles with me to 1 Timothy? 1 Timothy in chapter 5. Amen. Come on, you stand up here. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Amen. James has graciously embraced the Word of God, has studied to show himself approved, is currently an instructor in our BTC, our Bible Training Center, and is also going to be working with our Extension College campus through Life Christian University. We are actually going to be starting in the near future a fully accredited Life Christian University, and you will be blessed. Out of Tampa, Florida, we will be an Extension campus. I've worked with Dr. Doug Wingate, who is the dean of the university there before, and we've had previously, through another ministry, an Extension campus. And so we're excited to be able to offer accredited classes to further your wisdom, knowledge, and understanding as it pertains to the things of God. And so James will also be operating in that capacity. And so he will be a minister. We will address him as Minister Boyd. Amen. And he will be serving in our Christian education capacity as well as the dean of our university. And I'm so elated with that. I'm so glad and so thankful that God has brought him here to use his gifts, talents, and abilities to advance the kingdom of God. And everyone said, amen and amen. If you would, James, would you face me? And folks, if you're at 1 Timothy chapter 4, let's look at verse 12. James, the word of God says, let no man despise thy youth, but be thou an example of the believers in word, in conversation, in charity, in spirit, in faith, and in purity. Till I come, give attendance to reading, to exhortation, to doctrine. Neglect not the gift which is in thee by prophecy, with the laying on of hands of the presbytery. Meditate upon these things.